तस्मात्त्वमुत्तिष्ठ यशो लभस्व जित्वा शत्रून् भुङ्क्ष्व राज्यं समृद्धम् मयैवैते निहता पूर्वमेव निमित्तमात्रं भव सव्यसाचिम्
तस्मात्त्वमुत्तिष्ठ अराइज देयरफॉर यशो लभस्व एंड ऑब्टेन फेम हैविंग कॉन्कर्ड द एनिमीज एंजॉय दिस एफ्लुएंट किंगडम दे हैव बीन स्लेन बाय मी ऑलरेडी यू आर अ मियर इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ सव्यसाचिन व्हाट एन इनॉर्मसली पॉजिटिव फिलॉसफी इट्स अ हीरोइक फिलॉसफी इट्स अ डायनामिक वाइब्रेंट प्रिस्क्रिप्शन फॉर यंग पीपल एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली इट इज वी इंडियंस द रेसिपियंट्स ऑफ दिस मोस्ट फैंटास्टिक फिलॉसफी दैट आर रिजेक्टिंग इट बिकॉज वी बिलीव इट इज मेंट फॉर ओल्ड पीपल वी बिलीव इट इज नो कनेक्शन विद आवर लाइव्स ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ रॉन्ग मिसकंसेप्शंस वी हैव सो ऑल यू हैव टू डू is don't worry about the result. Stand up for your principles. Fix a goal. Act dynamically. Don't worry about the result. Whatever be the result, accept it. Where is that and where is this? And what is he saying? Conquer, enjoy, acquire fame. There's a direct statement. So what does it mean? There is no taboo in life. There is no taboo to prosperity. There's no taboo to power. There's no taboo to enjoyment. The only thing that the Vedanta is against is getting victimized by it, or being dependent on it, or conducting yourself in such a way that you lose yourself in it. That's all that they're saying. And he even removes the guilt from Arjuna. He says, I have already slain them. When he says, I have slain them, he means the law of karma is functioning. You be a mere instrument, or Savyasachin. Savyasachin means ambidextrous. Arjuna was ambidextrous, he was equally skillful with both hands. What it means is, you expert, every one of us is outstandingly talented, we have tremendous potential, we have enormous capabilities. Use them, be a mere instrument of the Lord. It is some divine force that has blessed us with these abilities. All you have to do is use it in the Lord's name, for the Lord. You offer it as an offering of gratitude to that divine force that has given it to you in the first place. What a fantastic philosophy. If each one of us goes back with just this one message, your life will change dramatically, miraculously. That most of us don't even know what we've been blessed with. We haven't even identified our talent. And all that we're doing is, you see, that less you're doing with yourself, the more negative you become with respect to others. And throughout this country is this negative strain. You watch news at 9 o'clock, you'll feel so depressed. Because the strangest of things are reported. Sometimes you wonder, is it true that all negative things are happening? Or is it just that we want to listen to all this? So, the problem is our own desires, our own weaknesses. As Arjuna says, baladiva niyojita, as if by force, even though we want to be positive in life, as if by force somebody is taking us into negative alleys in life. And therefore, it's extremely important that we reinforce the intellect. You must make an effort to rise above your own weaknesses and do something constructive with yourself. And say, even if it's a small thing, whatever little I can do, let me do it wholeheartedly. As the Gita, Krishna says elsewhere, sarva bhavena, with all your being. Every little act that you do, you must do wholeheartedly. Then you get the satisfaction. Doesn't matter what others say or don't say. You get the satisfaction that I've done my best. And that's all that matters. So, Savyasachin, every one of us is a Savyasachin, sitting here. Here, we don't even know what we can do with one right hand, leave alone both hands. So, uttishtha, wake up, get up, jagrata, don't get up right now. Jagrata, wake up, you're asleep to your own potential. You're asleep to the wonderful things that you are heir to. You're asleep to the magnificence and the grandeur that is there outside. When are you going to wake up, is what Krishna is telling us. Next verse.